What we did today was an experiment with Riverbot. We're testing its stability and how it tracks in the water, and we prefer to understand how this one behaves before we give it power. Okay. We've tested in pools before, but this is our first somewhat open water test. Riverbot is really a platform for scientists and students who want to study the lagoons. So we provide Riverbot as something like akin to the space shuttle, where other people bring us their payloads, what they want to run in the lagoon as an experiment. We actually have this vision for a student to start in middle school and take their research all the way to a PhD using our platforms and technology.
For the Riverbot, we hope to collect data that tells us the water quality, how polluted it is, and from that data, we hope to learn what ways or initiatives we can take to clean the river.
The ocean's full of plastic. These elements, these little pieces of plastic, may have started off as cups, they may have started off as bags, they could have started off as anything. And we actually found these tangled in with the seaweed that comes up on our beaches. And the reason we're concerned about this is that sea turtle hatchings are actually consuming this plastic and it's impacting their health.
If the community doesn't know what's going inside their water, then they won't know how to prevent the pollution that's entering the water or what responsibility they need to take on.
So when I became involved and started researching ocean health and different bodies of water, that's when I discovered what was happening in the lagoon, and it really is a much broader mission for us. But we have to start someone. We're starting here in Brevard because we know everything is connected.
Watch full episodes of SciTech Central Thursdays at 8:30 p.m. on WUCF-TV.